Hey guys, today we're going to work on a very common problem that happens when you're managing an AWS server. And that is when you've misplaced your key file and you cannot access your AWS instance, because Amazon only allows you to download your key file once. So the first step would be to let's create a new instance in the same availability zone. In this case, the server that we've lost the key file is the test server that I named here, and it's on the EU West 1B availability zone. So we're going to create another instance in the same availability zone. So let's go to launch instance, and we're just gonna go with Amazon Linux. The T2 micro, because we're going to destroy this instance after. We're going to terminate it once we get the new key file set up. And here you need to pay attention and make sure that you select EU West 1B, which is this one, and we go next and we go add tags, and I'm gonna just name it. The name would be new, we'll call it NewKey, and then we're going to security group, and this time we're just gonna open the SSH port 22 to be available anywhere, since we're going to destroy this instance. Once we are done with it, we'll review. And we click on launch, and then this is important. We need to create a new key pair, and we're going to call it new key. And we're going to download this. There you go, it's downloading right now. And then we're going to launch this instance. All right, so the instance is launching. We'll view our instances. Right, so now we have these two instances here. We have the new one we created in the same availability zone, okay, and we have the old server, the test server, which we don't have the key file for, and it's here. So the next step would be to remove the EBS volume from this test server instance and then attach it to the new key server instance that we just created. Now, to remove the EBS volume, to unmount it, what we need to do is to stop this test server, first of all, because it won't let you unmount it if it's still running. So we go to actions, instance state, stop. Click yes, stop. And sometimes this takes a couple of minutes. Now we've got the test server, it's stopped. So what we need to do is to detach the volume and attach it to this one. So we go from here to here. So now we go to the test server and we go to the root device, click on it, and this is the EBS volume ID. We click on it to jump into our volumes, and this is test server volume. So we click on it, click on detach volume, yes, detach. Can refresh it. Actually, it says it's available. Once it's available, it means that it has been detached, and now we're going to attach this volume to our new key instance, and we're going to give it SDF as the device name, and we're going to attach this. Wait for it to finish running. Okay, it should be done by now. Let's refresh. Okay, so it's done. And if we go back to our instances and we go to to the new key instance, you will see that we have 1, 2, 3, and this is the one from the test server that we attached just now. Okay, now we're going to move over to our terminal and clear all this out, and now we can start the process of copying the key file into the volume that we just attached. Alright, so now we've attached the EBS volume to the new key instance. Let's SSH into it and continue from there. Alright, so now we go into this instance and now we're logged in. We have to become root. Sudo minus I. Now we can make a directory. Key recovery. I'll press enter and we've created the directory. Next step would be to mount it. And we're gonna mount it here. And then the next step would be to append the key files to this new location. Okay, /.ssh and authorized keys. And we're going to put that in the new location. MNT new key recovery /home. Our server is actually Ubuntu, so we're gonna use Ubuntu as the user, and authorized keys. There you go. Okay, I will press enter and that's done. And now we're gonna unmount this volume. Done, and the next thing is to exit and exit. Okay, exit. Right, done. So basically we are done with our terminal updates. So the next thing is to go back here, detach and remount it to the server and test. So we're going to select that. Yes, detach. And of course it will take some time. Let's refresh just to see. Okay, so it's still in use. Still waiting for it to be done. Come on Amazon, let's go. We don't have all day. Oh yes, we have to actually stop the instance. we need to stop this instance before we can detach it. My bad. So we go to that, click stop. Yes. And we wait again. All right, so it's stopped right now. And apparently it's also detached the volume. So let's go back to volumes. And this is the volume that we want to attach. As you can see, it's now available. So we go back and we attach this volume. And we're gonna attach it to the test server volume, which is this one. And we're going to give it the primary SDA1, is what it should be. And we click attach. And it's done. So we go back to our instances. And we're gonna start this instance. Go to instance, start. Yes, start. Let's give it some time. There you go. So it's running right now. And if we connect, it's still showing that, but it's fine. We're going to use a different location, a different perm file for this connection. So what we can do is to try to connect and see if it worked. So let's take the username. Copy that. And go here. SSH minus I. File, which is this one, drop it in, and we put Ubuntu at EC2, press enter. Yes, we want to say yes, press enter, and boom, we're in. So basically, we are into our old EC2. Instance using a new key file that we just created. Thank you very much. I hope this has been helpful to you. My contact details are in the description below. Feel free to contact me if you have any questions. I'll try to answer them as best as I can. And do come back again and join me in my next tutorial, which will be about adding SSL to an Ubuntu instance. All right, take care guys. Bye bye.